So guys, hello and welcome to this tutorial. In the previous video, we were talking about the reshape function. So actually for reshaping an array, that is for changing a shape, changing the shape of an array, we use two functions. One is reshape and the second one is resize. So actually I'll tell you all the difference first on a little before starting. So reshape means basically we are changing the shape of the array, and resize means we are changing the number of elements of the array. So size means number of elements in that array, right? So we are just changing the size. But what happens while using this resize function, as we change the size, we can change the shape as well. So let us talk about it, in details now. So the syntax is numpy.resize. We have the original array name. This is the original array name. And then the new shape. That is only two parameters. Now, what does this resize do? It returns a new array with the specified shape. As the reshape function did, this is the same thing. But if the new array is larger than the original array, that is, if we specify some shape that, in reshape we had to care about the shape, because the shape had to be according to be the shape had to be mentioned according to the size of the array, original array. Over here we don't have to care about the size. We can, enlarge the size. We can, decrease the size of that array. So then the new array is filled with repeated copies of the original array. I'm going to talk about this repeated copies in a while explaining the example. So as I told you all, it will change the size of the array. Fine, it will change the size because it is resized. But it will also change the shape of the array. So it will change the size while changing the shape of that array. Fine. Now let us do one thing. Let us see some example. So let us have one function. I actually have imported numpy as NP. So we'll write arr equals to numpy.arrange. I'll use the arrange function. Let us have an array starting from 1 up to 6. So it will go from 1 up to 5 actually. Let us print out arr so that we understand what is happening. So we got arr from 1 to 5. Fine. That is fine. Now let us do one thing, let us use the resize function. So as the syntax is numpy.resize, and then there are only two parameters. One is going to be the original array name, which is arr, and then the new shape. So as I told you all, in the reshape we had, if there are five elements, then we had to enter the shape in that way. But where you can, increase the size, you can decrease the size according to the shape. So the shape is, suppose you want the shape to be, let us say 4,2, or let us say 2,4. Fine. And this is the new shape actually. Let us do one thing. Let us print it. Actually, we printed it out. So let us run this code. So see, this was the original array. Now this is the new array, and the shape is 2,4. That is 2 rows 1 and 2 and 4 columns 1, 2, 3, 4 columns. Now what did it do is, as I told you all in the slides, it will have the as soon as it will finish the original array's elements, it will start to print out the copies. So see, the original array has elements from 1 up to 5. So it printed out from 1 up to 5, but it again started from 1 up to 5. So it will go again from 1, 2, 3 and up to 5. It will not go, obviously, because the shape is 2,4. That is 2 into 4, 8 elements. So it has 8 elements. Fine. So actually, this was about resize. Actually, I can explain you one more thing. So actually, you can do one more thing. You can just decrease the size as well. So if you write 3,1 and run this code, this array will have only 3 elements, because 3 into 1 is 3, the shape is 3, so 3 elements. So actually we decrease the size from up to 1 to 3, and we didn't took 4,5. Fine. You can write 1,3 as well, so just for example. So you can do this as well. Now there is one more function actually, kind of function. So the syntax of this function is array name, that is the original array name, dot resize, and over here we have to enter new shape and reference value equals to true. I'm going to discuss about it in a while, so for now just ignore it. So what does it do? This function will change the original array. So we have to print the array by print statement on new line. So basically we need two statements. One statement is array name dot resize and the change shape as it is mentioned over here, the syntax, and afterwards we have to print it. So basically you can't print it out directly, and the most important difference is the missing elements are filled with zeros. There it was filled with copies of the original array's elements, here it will be filled by zeros. Fine. And I'm going to talk about the errors afterwards. So now let us try to use that function again. So if you have arr dot, as I told you all, the syntax is the array name, that is the original array name dot resize. So this is the original array name dot resize, and it has two parameters. One is the new shape and other is ref check. I'm going to talk about it afterwards, as I told you. So let us have the new shape as 4,3, and now run this code. So it will change the shape of the original array. So As I told you, you cannot print it out on the same line, but if you try to print out, it will print out none, if I'm not wrong. So let us check it and try to print it out. So if you try to print out, it will print out none, as I told you. So you can't do that. What you have to do is, because it just changes, this statement just changes the original array ARR. So that's why you just have to print out ARR again. What did I do? Hold on. Print ARR. So if you print out ARR now you'll get ARR as the new sized array. So it will print from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 5. And the difference was, it will not start from 1 again. It will actually fill the remaining entries with zeros. So 4 comma 3, that is 4 into 3, 12 elements. This is 4 comma 3, that is 4 rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 1, 2, 3 columns. So 12 elements in total. So this is one of the statements. Now, as I told you all, it can have an error. So I didn't tell you actually. I'm going to discuss it about now. About it now. So this is the error raised, value error. So if this ARR does not own its own data or references, so if you use any references, then it actually it will give us a value error. By reference, what do I mean is, so actually I will not use, actually I'll use that statement, but before that I'll use some reference. So if you have some B reference, that is a new variable B, and I'll set it equals to ARR. And now if you try to print it out, so actually even if you don't print out, even if you use this statement, still it will give us a value error. So it will not print it out obviously. Value error is, it cannot resize an array that has reference. So we have used B to get reference, right? We have basically, what you did, you just copied, you can say. So you cannot do that actually. So, but what if you want to, you know, still you don't want to get that error. So what you do, you have to, now comes the, you know, the second parameter, that is ref check equals to false, because by default it is set as true. Hold on, where is the syntax? Yeah, so by default the value of ref check is set as true. This is the new shape as I discussed. So you know, to get the error out, you just have to set ref check equals to false. So if you check it and run this code, it will not print it out because I didn't print it out. I'll have to print out ARR, and now run this code. Now it will print out ARR. Let us do one thing. I'll print out ARR first. So print ARR and run this code. It will print out ARR. This is the original array. This is the new array, or the changed array actually. This is the ARR actually. This was ARR, and this is ARR again. But what if, hold on, I can do one thing. I can set the reference check equals to true. So if I don't write anything, it means the reference check equals to true. And now if I have set B equals to ARR and I try to print out ARR, it will give us an error, as I told you all. But what if you write B dot resize and run this code? See, still it gave us an error, because whatever it is, B or A, we just copied the element, so we can't do that. So if you want to get out, you know, get out the error, you just have to write ref check equals to false. Hold on, what did I do? False. So just simply false and run this code. It will not give us the array. I always forget it. I don't know why. You have to print out B again. So if you print out B, it will give us the new array. And you can do one more thing. You can print out ARR as well. What if you try to print out ARR? ARR is equal to B, so it will, B and ARR will be same. So this was the original array, this is the array B, and this is the ARR. So actually B and ARR, this RR, what is it? B and ARR are the same value, same arrays. So that's why it will print out the same arrays on new lines. So I think that's all from my side for this tutorial. I'm going to talk about, you know, manipulation in arrays in the future tutorials. So until then, you can stay tuned and keep learning. You can watch, subscribe to my channel for more such programming related content. Thank you.